All right, Brush on Review, Ezekiel here. Next anime up, we have Failure Frame. I became the strongest and annihilated everything with low-level spells. All right, let me give you a quick synopsis. Basically, Toka, him and his classmates end up getting summoned to another world. Upon their arrival, they meet the goddess, and it turns out that Toka is an E-level E-level adventurer or magician, just E-level person. He's the lowest out of all his classmates, and she basically treats him as a failure, and he plots his revenge, right? Just simple, easy, that's it. And a part of his gifts, when he gets summoned and they all get gifts, he has low-level spells like the title says. So he has poison, paralysis, and sleep. And as the story progresses, he gets, you know, well, as the story progresses, obviously he gets stronger. He's, you know, the title says it itself. All right, so what do I think about this one? This one is good. I like this one. I like this one better than I like The Strongest Magician in the Demon Army. This one had me hook, line, and sinker because the revenge plot. I love revenge plots. So just like I like overpowered characters, I like certain reincarnations, I love revenge plots. My light novels I read, I like it when they build up the revenge and the protagonist goes for the revenge, or the protagonist gets even with the character or the bully. I love that stuff, right? Probably because I was bullied growing up. I love it. This one had me glued to my seat. I'm on episode 10, and I'm almost willing. You know it's a good series if I have to watch it week by week, like the big three back in the day. It's almost there, but not quite. You know what I'm saying? I think the tension build up, similar to Shield Hero. I think they, you know, Shield Hero did a very, very good job with the revenge and the build up and everything. This one took a little bit of a shorter route. So we get, I don't want to go into spoilers yet until it's done, but we get a backstory to the character, which is sad. I'm not going to go into details. It's just the backstory was sad. We get into all that. And as you go along with the series, of course, he has to be able to use these three spells strategically. And I think I like that. Like I said, I like smart characters. I like revenge stories. And I like summoning or reincarnation stories. So this has it all in one. You get to see how smart he is. You get to see how he is very strategic and tech. Well, not overly strategic. I won't give him that much credit. You know, some of that stuff was pretty straightforward, but he does a pretty good job. The animation, when you talk about anime, you got to talk about the animation. Animation was good. I like the anime. You know, they do a little bit of the 3D going backwards. Was it all 3D? No, it was a fancy anime. It's fancy. A little bit 3D here and there, just like they do with Kingdom. But it was fine. It was, I won't say believable, but it put me in the world. You're like, I like animes with certain art styles is just too crazy and too over the top where I can't get drawn into the story. So others like this, it's good and I can get drawn in. I'm fine. You know, Wand and Sword, I think is the best I've seen so far this season for animes, but so this was fun. Let me see. I don't want to give too much up, so I think you guys should check it out. If you like revenge plots, if you like a character becoming OP, he doesn't start off OP, he slowly becomes OP. Yeah, I think you guys should check this out. Hopefully he gets to season 2, because I don't see a resolution, a little bit of a spoiler, a little bit. I don't see a resolution by episode 10, so 9 out of 10, they're doing 12 episodes. He's probably going to get a season 2 if it does pretty good. And that's it. Tell me, guys, what you think about this one. Worldstorm Reviews, Ezekiel. Peace.